feels like everything's in alignment now.
How many? I mean, how much do you try and bounce around and see different high schools?
I try to make it a point every week too. There's a few games I have circled.
Yeah.
But for the most part, you know, I try to get around and watch all the Sooner 7 kids, all the kids I've trained. And so, you know, Friday at 5, I get Case. And, you know, we'll go. I think we're going to Rejoice and Luther this week to watch Chance Wilson. And then next week we'll be at Choctaw Booker T.
I like Chance Wilson.
Yeah, he's a good kid.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's got a good frame, good athlete. And like I said, next week obviously we'll go down and watch Booker T goes to Choctaw, so that'll be littered with.
Is that next week?
I think it's the 24th. Yeah, so
yeah.
Not this week, but
I'll
next.
I'll see it. That'll be my first Choctaw game this season. So
yeah, that'll be a good one.
And a lot of people know those guys. You and I were just talking. Deshaun Brown is like high on Oklahoma State's list right now.
Right.
You've got a bunch of guys from there. Cade McConnell is a kid. I've known his dad, Aaron, forever, and Cade's committed to TCU. And then, of course, you know, you got QB1 down there.
Yeah, Steele's
so
down there.
Steele Wassel. And,
you got a bunch of kids. I mean, the Sooner 7 guys that we had come out from, you know, from Choctaw and Booker T, you know, with LaMarion and Latrell and Jack Smith. And then on the Booker T side, you got Aiden Walker, Micah Tease. You know, Gentry played when, 2 years ago, and then obviously last year he didn't play because of his injury. But it was good seeing Gentry. I went to Southmore game, saw him back playing again, and it was just good to see.
And I've watched him a couple of times now, and you can tell he's still getting over, and you know this, you've seen this with guys just like I have. There's the mental hurdle coming off that injury.
Right.
And he's still getting over the mental hurdle.
Yeah, I would say that. I mean, I watched him this summer a few times when we would throw, and he's moving back to normal in that kind of setting. But anytime, you know, you get out there around
Martin Bullets. We're talking about Gentry Williams.
Gentry Williams, yeah. And, you know, and that's the mental thing. But he's back to 100%. It's just that getting back into your old mental groove of doing what you do after
and
something
not,
like that
and
happened.
And not thinking about it.
And not thinking about it.
Exactly.
Yep.
So, all right, let's go through quarterbacks. People always want to know who the quarterbacks are that are out there. And I know you saw my son. He was out last week. He saw Stillwater and Mustang. And he goes, Dad, Gage is you know, Gage Gundy is really coming on. And then he went over to the game you were at, which was Perkins and Cushing. And you got two good quarterbacks over there. But just kind of run me through some of these quarterbacks.
Yeah. you know, I haven't watched Gage as much, but he's grown a lot.
Oh, man.
I think last time I saw him, we were eye to eye. The time before that, I think he was 6 foot. So that happened about, seems like a year. And then, yeah, the Cushing Perkins game, Blaze Berlowitz at Cushing. I mean, he's, you know, every bit 6'3", throws a good ball. He's got some good athletes to throw to. And then, you know, I saw your son talking about Gunner Thrash at Perkins.
Right.
You know, this is his first year starting. He's done a good job. Other kids we have in Sooner 7. So, you know, we got Wassel at Choctaw. He's done well this year so far. I don't know how many touchdowns, but not a lot of touchdowns, not many turnovers. They ran into a little speed bump last week against Jesuit in Dallas. But that's a solid tap school down
It's not a tap school anymore. They're UIL.
Oh, they are. Really? Okay.
They are UIL. And I mean and doing well in the UIL.
Yeah, they've got a couple kids that we had seen on the 7-on-7 circuit that are just, you know, good football players. And so that was a good test for them. And then, you know, some of our other guys we have Gavin Frakes is having a big year at Norman North. Gavin's a great athlete. He's kind of a deceptive athlete because he is extremely fast for 6'4", 200 pounds. And then, you know, Carson Trimble's having a good year at Grove. Chance Wilson, obviously, a Rejoice. And then we have, it was on quite a bit of media last week, but our 15U quarterback, who's a freshman, Shaker.
Yeah.
Came in last week for Jinx and won the backyard bowl. I think he threw two touchdowns. Shaker's 15. You know, I met Shaker and his father a couple of years ago when he first moved from
New York.
Upstate New York. And, you know, he's a good kid. He's beyond his years and maturity. He's very, when he comes, it's very businesslike, and his father's that way. And so it kind of carries over to him. But Shaker, you know, came in and had a good game. And then, we had a move-in kid just started coming out named David McComb. He's a freshman at Edmond Memorial, about 6'3", 190. He's thrown a couple varsity touchdowns this year. I'm really high on him. I think he's going to be a great player as time progresses. So, in my opinion, in the state of Oklahoma, freshman, you got two kids that are going to be pretty high-end, and McComb and Shaker. I mean, those are both high-end kids.
I don't know how big Shaker will end up getting, but I've already heard from some people who have seen him play, and maybe it was winning the Backyard Bowl the way his team did, because let's be honest, that's a game that's generally not won that demonstratively. And there's some people believe that he's going to be one of those huge national guys when he gets to be a junior and senior.
Yeah, I mean, he's right at, I mean, right now, I mean, the way the game's moved, you know, he's right at 6 foot at 15.
That's not bad.
I mean, you get another inch or two and you're fine.
Yeah.
To be honest, you're fine at 6 foot anymore. It just depends on your arm slot. But, I truly believe that, you know, he's going to be a great player. And like I said, he's mature beyond his years. And so I don't think he really got rattled. You know, he's just the kind of kid, he just goes in and does what he's supposed to do.
Big game this week is in 6A2, where Stillwater will go up to Bixby. And that's the thing. Bixby's got tons. Yeah, I mean, you know a lot of these kids because they've been on your Sooner 7 teams. Braylon right. Presley, Luke Haas. I mean,
Dylan, Jacob Snyder.
Exactly.
Josh Newkirk.
And the thing is, Bixby, I haven't seen Bixby play yet
right.
this season. But the thing I've heard is the difference in them is their quarterback play. And you realize you can have all these weapons, but if you don't have that trigger mechanism to get the ball to them, it can hold you up. And I know Bixby's still unbeaten. They're still ranked number one. But it's kind of like this Oklahoma State offense. People are all frustrated because it's not popping out 40, 50 points a game, and it's not throwing out 400 and 500 yards a game. And, and some of these games with Bixby have been a little tighter. I don't even know who's playing quarterback for them. You probably do.
Yeah, I think they've played a couple kids there. I want to say there's a Burke kid, and then there's a Kirby kid they run some packages with. Actually, I just started working with Kirby's little brother. But, yeah, you know, at the end of the day, yeah, everybody wants to score 40 or 50, but a win's a win. And, you know, you kind of got to go with what – dance with who brought you, so
yeah.
to speak, and figure out what works. And I think Bixby's to a point now where when Bixby plays people, yeah, they have the talent, but people – they're also playing a helmet.
Yeah.
And so when they step on the field, it's still Bixby. They still expect to beat you. And they seem to always find a way. You know, Schneider and Montgomery over there do a great job
yeah.
of putting their best players on the field and putting them in positions to make plays.
Yeah.
And regardless, you know, Bixby is a, you know, they're
going
to put their guys in the right spot.
If they have to, and we've seen Bixby do this before, especially, they usually save it for the playoffs, but understand they've already gone to it some. They're just getting a wildcat.
Yeah, getting the wildcat. I think that
with a great athlete, let that athlete go, baby.
Is that 2 years ago? 2 or 3 years ago, I remember they came. I think it was the state championship, and they just put Cade Cavender back there at quarterback,
sure.
and I think he rushed for like 270.
And
you know, they have wrinkles like that, and you know, that's just a testament to what they do, putting their guys in position. But yeah, I'm looking forward to kind of seeing the outcome of that game. I think that kind of sets the, you know, you got that game that week, and then the next week you got Booker T. Choctaw, so I think you'll have a lot better kind of idea of what's going to happen and transpire in 6A2 after those two games take place.
All right, we're going to take a time out here. We'll come back with more. So we will welcome back to Sports Talk with Robert Allen and friends. We get into the noon hour, and we're here at the Smoky Pokey restaurant, and can tell you, I've already talked about those Cattleman burgers that Casey has talked about. They've got great wings here. You can choose from honey, garlic, buffalo, or barbecue, or you can have them plain. They've got that pork belly BLT, a generous portion of their signature smoked pork belly, which, you know, is like a high-end bacon, with lettuce, tomato, and between two slices of Texas toast. So awesome. Sandwich here at the Smoky Pokey. They've always got the smokehouse going here. Their favorites are sliced pork, chopped brisket, hot links, smoked sausage, sliced bologna, and then they got the ribs, and then their premium smokehouse meats are pulled pork, sliced turkey, grilled chicken, and that pork belly. Mm-mm-mm. Good stuff. Breakfast in the morning. It's good all the time here at the Smoky Pokey. All right, let's get back with Derek Rasmussen here, and want to talk. Let you talk about some of your things. Anybody out there got a young quarterback? Want some training? You're to me the preeminent guy in the state. Tell folks what you're doing, and what ages? Ideally, what ages? I know you have a young group, and then you have the older group. Kind of give people a lowdown on the quarterback training.
I started going a little bit younger just due to, I had a lot of parents asking. And so, I try to split up the groups, the younger ones, the older ones. Typically I start, I get kids as young as, fourth grade, fifth grade. With them, I basically focus more on, base and stuff like that, and just recognition of just football terms, outs and different concepts, and we get good work in. And then obviously with the older kids, and we when they're about eighth grade, seventh grade, I start jumping into biomechanics and all those different things. And basically the thing that I focus on is we do all the rhythm stuff, but for the most part the game's changed so much. You got to be able to throw from different arm slots, you got to be able to throw on the move, you got to be able to throw, just basically generate power from a lot of different ways. And that's just the way the game is, with RPOs and play actions. And you see it on Sundays and Saturdays now, and it's a little unorthodox, but at the end of the day, if I can get kids to put kids in a situation in a training setting that then they see on a Friday night or a Tuesday night or a Monday night, then it's worth it, because they've been there before and now they know what to do. So,
and I've seen that. I've been to some of his sessions, and they do a lot of things that they're just trying to duplicate scenarios that you would be out in a game on the field. And Derek has a bunch of different drills that I think have come in handy. By the way, I meant to say this last segment. I know you had Darwin Thompson at some of your training sessions. From Jinx, and then he went to NEO and Utah State and Kansas City Chiefs recently. Did you see who picked him up?
Tampa Bay.
Yeah, Tampa Bay. So he's down there with
him. I'm happy for him. He's a good guy, man.
Yeah.
He's one of a kind, man. He'll outwork anybody, and he's just waiting for his opportunity now.
Yeah, and my understanding was, inquiring, was that Brady had a hand in it, said, hey, I'd like, let's bring that guy in. He might be kind of fun to work with. And the one thing about Darwin is, like you say, he's a hard worker, but even for his size, he doesn't mind pass pro, doesn't mind protecting the quarterback. And he also is kind of an interesting receiver out of the backfield, even with his size. So, all right, we talk a little bit about training. Let's talk a little bit about the app, because that's something you guys came up with, about a year and a half ago?
Yeah, two and a half, I think.
Long?
I'd say.
Time flies.
Yeah, it has, man. It's been a long, short 2.5 years. January 1, as of, I'd say about 2 months ago, we're the official recruiting partner of Texas High School Coaches Association.
Awesome.
So that was a big deal for us, and then we just sealed up the state of North Carolina.
Which reminds me, have you seen the quarterback at Owosso?
Austin Havens. Yeah.
Havens.
Yeah, Austin came out this summer a few times. Yeah, he's a North Carolina kid.
Yeah, and I like him.
Yeah, he's good.
He's got a lot of good receivers at Owosso.
Hey,
they collect good receivers.
Owosso's receiving core with Keelan Carney and the other two. Obviously Keelan's a kid that I've been high on for a few years. I love Keelan. He's Army offered, got a couple. But yeah, he's got three really good receivers. I mean, three kids that are gonna play D2 and above football.
Absolutely.
FCS, probably FCS. Even possibly Group of Five, Power Five kids. So, and they've got dudes up at Owosso. They got a they got a machine going up there right now.
Yeah, and the guy that and I'm trying to look it up.
Is it Jare Austin?
No.
Is that his name?
No, it's Cole Adams.
Cole Adams.
I did not mean
to forget about Cole. Cole's the only 2023 one they got. But, yeah, so Cole is special. I saw him at the show, and he had cut his hair, and so I didn't recognize who it was. But
he cut it all off.
Everybody
yeah.
was talking. They were like, "Who's that kid?" And somebody was like, "I don't know. It's probably a receiver from Texas or something." And I got down closer. I'm like, "Is that Cole Adams?" And yeah. I got down on the field, and I was like, "Okay, yeah, that makes sense." And he's just, you know, his top end speed is spectacular, and he is just, you know, you can
you
tell.
You know who he reminds me of? He really does remind me of Wes Welker.
Wes Welker, yeah.
A lot.
He's got that. I mean, he literally has that potential. And you, if you watch his huddle, you know, some of the catches Cole makes in traffic for a guy his size are just, you're like, whoa, you're not supposed to be, you know, you're supposed to run the digs and the crossers, yeah. not go up and get a ball over two guys. But he's so athletic, and he's you can tell he's a heady football player as well. He's got a lot of savvy.
Anyway, if somebody wants to get with the app,
right,
which allows – if you haven't been noticed and you think, hey, I want to play college football, this is the way to go.
Right. Yeah. We have over 200 schools now, 250. I think last time I was on here, I think it was about 125. We're approaching 250 schools now on the colleges on the platform. State of Texas, the way Texas works is it goes through the high school. So the high school has to come on. But, you know, organically, you could just go to Signing Day Sports in the state of Oklahoma. Basically, you can download the app. There's a free portion of the app. So if you're listening.
Sure.
And your kids are in high school, you can go download the app and put your measurements in there. There's a place for you to video verify everything, your height, your weight, your hand size, your wingspan, your 5'10", 5". Basically, all we're trying to do is anything a college coach would ever come out to see, you house in that. And,
yeah, and
that, that's the free portion. Then, obviously, there's an upgraded with the pro day and the interviews. But, I mean, you can go download the app, get your kids' information in there. And, yeah, it's been a fun ride for the last 2.5 years.
Yeah, and again, getting more popular by the day. All right, let's talk. I know coaches are, you know, and you've been, you know, you're a coach and always hesitant to second guess other coaches, but obviously observations. And, one of my biggest observations with Oklahoma State is they just need some lineup stability, but you've seen some of the Cowboys. Your thoughts?
I think the game against Tulsa, it's kind of like a zigzag thing, as I call it. So it's like, you know, when somebody's zigging, somebody else is zagging. And I felt like the times, you know, sometimes they're like when the pocket was clean, timing was off because of redirects at the line of scrimmage. And then, you know, at the end of the day, youth, you know, That can be a crutch, but it can also be, you know, it can also be your bell cow. And I think right now, and I mean, I'll just say it. I mean, you're not going to find a young receiving core with as much talent as Oklahoma State has right now. Now, there's probably some around the country, but I mean, with Jaden Bray, Presley, JP, the twins, you know, you've got kids that are going to start to understand what Dunn and Gundy want done. And as that happens, I mean, the sky's the limit for this offense. But, you know, I think we talked about it the other day. There were some instances where, you know, there were some creases at times, and then there were times where there wasn't. And I think just, you know, with such a young team, I think there's going to be those growing pains, and I think you're going to find out a lot Saturday, you know, against a team like Boise State that expects to win up there. I mean, that's a tough place to play.
Oh, they don't lose up there.
They don't lose very often.
Not very much, no. Now, they also, and I found out this, I thought they probably signed a lot of two-for-one deals. They haven't had a Pac-12 team come in and play them there at their place. I thought
in a while.
Surely, yeah, I thought.
I think the last one I remember was when they beat Oregon, and then the guy got knocked out on the field by LeGarrette Blunt. You remember that?
Maybe.
That might have been.
Yeah.
Oregon went in and got beat, so that tells you why the Pac-12 doesn't come back.
They can't get Pac-12 schools now to come in and play them. And I've seen some, but, you know, Oklahoma State, this is a little bit like when you go to Troy. You know, it's hey, you feel like there's a black cauldron at midfield with boiling water, and you're the one that they're going to put in it.
Right.
You know, you've got to get past that feeling, and we'll see how this Oklahoma State team does with that.
And, I mean, that travel schedule, too, I mean, that's something Oklahoma State's going to have to do once every 2 years here soon with BYU, you know, going up to Provo.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll be honest, that's not an easy place to go get a win either.
No. And it's like when you had to, you know, again, when you went to Colorado.
Right.
You know, and you know, a lot of coaches will go in early, and Mike Gundy's not going a day early, but they're leaving in the morning so they can get to the stadium, spend a little time there, get used to the blue turf. And yeah. Also, like, used to me, the bigger deal is the altitude.
Yeah, the altitude, that plays a part. You know, my little brother played at Air Force, and, you know, you don't know until you know, but it's serious when you sure. when you get up there. But no, back to the Oklahoma State thing. You know, I didn't see red flags. I saw opportunities missed. But when you have young people around, that's going to happen. But I mean, as far as talent goes, I mean,
no.
you know where I stand on those kids, Braylon and Jaden and the twins and all those guys. I mean, Dominique Richardson, the running backs. They have the like I said, the opportunities are there, and they're going to start capitalizing.
Yeah, and I love the fact that Richardson came in. And his stat line didn't end up being great, but he came in and shook off a couple of pretty good runs and kind of got things, you know, clicking a little bit. So, whether it's college or NFL, some other quarterbacks, some other things you've seen across the country that have impressed you.
Oh man. I was really impressed with, I guess the things I would say outside Georgia's defense.
Yeah. Against Clemson.
Against Clemson,
yeah.
I never thought I'd see anything like that with DJ. Because in my opinion, like I told you about DJ
way,
for four or five
that,
years.
Did Malcolm Rodriguez ever do any when
no.
he was at Wagner as a quarterback?
No,
he didn't have time because he's a wrestler, a
right.
baseball shortstop.
Well, I didn't get into the space really until probably 5 years ago.
Yeah,
we did have this Jaden Snyder come over.
Yeah.
He was there, and then he ended up. He was at Fort Dibbs and then went to Wagner, and I think he's a kicker now at Pitt State, and his brother is one of the better players at Bixby. You know, he had came over from Wagner, but Georgia's defense, that just kind of opened my eyes. Quarterback-wise, I was really impressed. Obviously, he had, you know, some weapons to throw to, but, you know, Bryce Young out of the gate. I mean,
yeah.
You know, he's just – if you watched him when he played at Modern Day – I mean, that's just what he did. He just doesn't really make mistakes. It doesn't seem like he gets rattled. And we'll see as the SEC season progresses. Obviously, you'll get thrown into some stuff. And then I thought the Arkansas win last week
was huge. I
was going to
say the Arkansas quarterback. Now, I don't know what his down the line, I don't know how good he is going to be with his arm. But he is an impressive runner. Yes.
A.J. Green, too. That was a kid that did not play Sooner 7 because of track. Because he was a big track guy in high school. But a good kid I've known for, you know, going on three, four years now. You know, he had, I think, 7 carries for 72 and a touchdown. You know, it's just good seeing those kids from Tulsa. You know, Miles Slusher's over there, Keewon Parker, Javion
yeah.
Hunt, you know, the kicker from Southmore. You know, they've got a little – with Odom over there,
the
they've got a little –
The offensive lineman over there from
Stromberg.
Stromberg.
Well, and everything I'm reading on Stromberg right now, he's one of the top guys in the country right now in
oh, yeah.
college
he got,
football.
He got some really good pub the other night.
Yeah, he's a ball player. But, yeah, that was impressive. And then, you know, we'll see. I think, you know, hoping Oklahoma State comes out and plays well and gets some of those fixed. And, you know, I don't know what the score is going to be, but I could see that game being maybe a classic Big 12, you know, four touchdowns apiece. But the defense for Oklahoma State, I will say too, has been very, you know, has been impressive the first 2 weeks.
Yeah, it'll be interesting because two teams, Boise comes in only averaging 70 yards a game on the ground. Oklahoma State comes in averaging just almost 90 on the ground.
Right.
So two teams that have not been able to run the ball really well.
You know how that story normally goes. Then they're going to both double their rushing outputs when nobody thinks they can run.
Well,
so.
Nothing would surprise me on
yeah.
that blue turf up there. So,
yeah.
All right. Well, hey, again, appreciate it. We'll need to have Derek on again, maybe as we get toward the playoffs in high school and like I said, I'll see you at that Choctaw. Booker T. Washington game next week.
Yeah, that'll
be
that Choctaw Booker T. Washington, and then I think 2 weeks later, Choctaw comes back home again, and Bixby comes to town. So
yeah. They
got some good 6A2 games coming up. It'll definitely be worth the watch.
Yeah, those will definitely be good games. Derek Rasmussen, where can folks get a hold of you?
My Instagram and Twitter is just my name, Derek Rasmussen. And then as far as signing day sports, it's just signingdaysports.com. You guys can go in there, take a look, kind of walk you through. We have football, baseball's in a soft launch right now, and then softball, which is going to be huge for the state of Oklahoma.
Sure.
Because I say this is the mecca when it comes to softball.
Well, they proved that this summer with that team that went and won the Little League softball series.
They did, and so softball will be available.
Out of Muskogee.
Out of Muskogee. And, but they had a girl from Morrison, I saw.
Well, that girl's all over.
Yeah.
It's a travel team.
It is, yeah. So we will softball will be ready to go here in the next month and a half, and we're looking to kick that off. Paige Halstead is leading the charge on that, the UCLA catcher.
Mm-hmm.
So I work with her. You know, I talk to her a couple times a day as we're getting this thing off the ground and going. But I think softball is gonna be really, really good for us. And it'll be kind of like the first time that something's like this in that space. So I'm excited.
All right.
Thanks for having me on,
Derek
Robert.
Rasmussen.